So class 10, today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, carbon and its compounds. So here we will study about the carbon. First of all, we will see the bonding in carbon, which type of bond formation takes place in the carbon. So in the previous class, we had already studied about the ionic compounds, their bonding and their properties. Like ionic compounds, they have high melting and boiling points. They conduct electricity in solution or in the molten state, and we also have studied that the nature of the bonding in ionic compounds explain the properties. Similarly, if we will study about the carbonic compounds, then most of the carbon compounds, they are poor conductors of electricity. Their boiling and melting points of the carbon compounds are very low. So we can say that because they have low melting and boiling points as compared to ionic compounds, we can conclude that the forces of attraction between the molecules are not very strong. So these compounds are largely non-conductors of electricity. So we can conclude that this bonding in these compounds doesn't give rise to any ions. So already we have studied in the class 9 that the combining capacity of an element, that is called valency, and how it depends on the number of valence electrons. So if we will consider the carbon, then the carbon atomic number is 6, and if we will see the electronic configuration, then it has 4 valence electron. Like carbon atomic number is 6, so it can be arranged as K cell is having 2 electrons, L cell is having 4 electrons, so it has 4 valence electrons. And the reactivity of an element is explained as their tendency to attain a complete filled outer shell, that is to attain a noble gas configuration. That means their outer shell should be of 8 electrons. They all try to complete the outer shell, fill the outer shell, and that is also known as octet rule. So the elements forming ionic compounds, they achieve this either by gaining or losing the electrons from the outermost shell, like we had done in the previous chapter. So they were losing the electron or gaining the electron from the outermost cell. But in case of carbon, if we will consider, it has 4 electrons. In case of carbon, it has 4 electrons in the outermost cell and needs to gain or lose 4 electrons to gain noble gas configuration. It is having only 4 electrons, so other it has to gain or it has to lose the 4 electrons to get the noble gas configuration. So if it were to gain or lose electrons, then what will happen? So suppose it could gain 4 electrons. So if it will gain the 4 electrons, then it will be C4 minus anion. C4 minus anion, negative ion. So it can be known as C4 minus anion. So but it would be difficult for the nucleus with 6 protons to hold on to 10 electrons, that is 4 extra electrons. So that is why it is not possible. If this is one case, if to gain electrons, if another case we will see, if it is losing electrons, then it is C4 plus cations, forming the cation. But it would require a large amount of energy to remove 4 electrons. It's not 1 or 2 electrons, it is 4 electrons. So it require a large amount of energy to remove 4 electrons, leaving behind a carbon cation with 6 protons in its nucleus, holding on to just 2 electrons. So carbon overcomes this problem by sharing its valence electron with other atoms of carbon or with atoms of other elements. That is why carbon started forming bond, like carbon with carbon or carbon with any other elements. So in this manner, not just carbon, many elements form molecules by sharing electrons in this manner, like oxygen, hydrogen. The shared electrons belong to the outermost shell. Only we are considering the outermost shell of both the atoms and lead to both atoms attaining the noble gas configuration. So carbon is compound is little bit difficult. So first of all, we will start from simple molecule by sharing the valence electron, and the simplest molecule is the hydrogen. Simplest example we can take is hydrogen, how it is forming H2 molecule. For hydrogen, atomic number is 1. We know that hydrogen atomic number is 1, that means its configuration, the 1 that will be come in the K cell. So its atomic number is 1, and it is near to the noble gas, that is helium, which एटॉमिक नंबर इज 2, हीलियम एटॉमिक नंबर इज 2, सो हाइड्रोजन इज नियर टू हीलियम हुज आउटर मोस्ट सेल इज हैविंग 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन, सो इट हैज टू कंप्लीट इट्स आउटर मोस्ट सेल विद 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन टू अटेन नोबल गैस कॉन्फिगुरेशन. सो 2 हाइड्रोजन एटम्स शेयर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स टू फॉर्म ए नोबल गैस कॉन्फिगुरेशन, सो फॉर दैट 2 हाइड्रोजन एटम्स आर रिक्वायर्ड. सो हियर वी कैन आइडेंटिफाई द आउटर मोस्ट सेल इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विथ क्रॉस और डॉट्स ऑल्सो वी कैन यूज. सो हियर वी विल सी दैट 2 हाइड्रोजन एटम्स शेयर देयर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अमंग द 2 टू फॉर्म ए बॉन्ड. To form a bond, so after sharing, now you can see this hydrogen atom has one electron and this hydrogen atom has one electron. So hydrogen, this hydrogen and this hydrogen, they are sharing their electrons. So one hydrogen is getting 2. Here this hydrogen is also getting 2 electrons. So they are getting a noble gas configuration, or their outermost shell is filled by 2 electrons, forming a bond that is called H2 molecule. That is called hydrogen molecule. So the shared pair of electron is said to be constituted a single covalent bond between 2 hydrogen atoms, and the covalent bond is represented by a line. Covalent bond is represented by line between 2 atoms. So here when the electrons are shared between the 2 atoms, so that is called covalent bond. Bonds which are formed by sharing of an electron between the 2 atoms, these are known as covalent bonds. And the covalent bond, these molecules are seen to have strong bonds within the molecule, but the intermolecular forces are weak. So this give rise to low melting and boiling points of the compounds. So here we can say that the bonds which are formed by the sharing of an electron between 2 atoms are known as covalent bond. And since the electrons are shared between the atoms and no charged particles are formed, so covalent compounds are generally poor conductors of electricity. So now let us see some more example. Like this is hydrogen, we can see oxygen, how oxygen molecule is formed. So in case of oxygen, atomic number of oxygen is 8. So its configuration we can write as 2 and 6, and in its outermost shell 6 electrons are there. So it needs 2 more electrons to complete its octet. So since outermost shell is having only 6 electrons, so it needs 2 more electrons to complete its octet. So that is why it share 2 electrons with another atom of oxygen to give the structure like this. So 2 oxygen shares 2 electrons with each other to form, to get the octet rule, to satisfy the octet rule, or to complete its outermost shell with 8 electrons. Like one oxygen is having 6 electrons, so when they share the electrons, so now you can see this oxygen is having 2, 4, 6 and 8 electrons, and this oxygen is also having 8 electrons. So now here you can see the electrons contributed by each oxygen atom give rise to 2 shared pairs of electrons. So here it is said to be constituted double bond between the atoms. So since in the previous here only one pair of electron was there, so it constitutes a single bond. But here 2 pair of electrons are shared, so that is why it constitutes double bond between the 2 atoms. So another example I am taking of covalent bond, the like molecule of water H2O, how it is formed. So we know H2O hydrogen atomic number is 1 and oxygen atomic number is 8. So it can be arranged as 2 and 6. So oxygen outermost shell is having 6 electrons and hydrogen is having only 1 electron. So hydrogen needs 1 electron to complete its outermost shell near to the noble gas configuration, and oxygen needs 2 more electron to complete its outermost shell with 8 electrons, or for the octet rule. So here 2 hydrogen atoms reacts with the oxygen. 2 hydrogen atoms share their electrons with oxygen because oxygen also required 2 more electrons to complete its octet. So 2 hydrogen atoms share electrons with oxygen to get the noble gas configuration completed, to get the near noble gas configuration, or to form the covalent bonding. For example, like here you can can see the structure. Oxygen is having for better understanding here, hydrogen electron I had taken in the dot and oxygen electron is cross. So you can see oxygen is having 6 electrons, 2, 4, 5, 6, and hydrogen is having only 1 electron. So hydrogen and oxygen, they share electrons. So now this hydrogen is having 2 electrons, and here also after sharing, this hydrogen is having 2 electrons and oxygen is having 8 electrons, or oxygen is able to complete its octet like 2, 4, 6, and 8. So this is also an example of covalent bonding. So in the you can practice these structures. In the next class we will discuss some more examples how covalent bonding is taking place.